You're watching Langley TV and this is the Midweek Roundup. Gus, you predicted a tough game against Manningham in last week's show. It turned out to be that with a 1-1 draw. What's your thoughts on the game?
Well, I thought it took us 20 minutes to get to grips with them. Their pressure was immense and they're a good side. And I'd watched them, as I'd said to you. I warned everybody, I warned the players. And it took us a good 20 minutes. But once young Curry got on the ball and they managed to get a couple cut back, it could have been 2 or 3 just before half-time. Got them in at half time, and obviously Liam Baxter, good goalie, scored. And I told them if they don't concede, then you've got the 3 points. With 45 minutes to go, and I thought the turning point was the very soft sending off of Johnny Guthrie. There were some heavy tackles going in from both sides. I thought the referee was just a wee bit severe with Johnny's second yellow. It gave them obviously the impetus to come at us, and they did. And fortunately for us, they had the man sent off also. And I think that evened the game out a bit. They certainly had a lot of chances, but I thought we could deny the Stonewall penalty, even showed on the replay. The referee said it hit his chest and the linesman half flag up, half down, and I had a wee word with him after the game, but he said they left it to the referee and the referee said it hit his chest, but it was an absolute blatant penalty. And obviously there's two skirmishes just at the very end. We could have snatched it, but I think a 1-1 draw was a fair result. Manningham are a good side.
So you mentioned the sending off of Johnny Guthrie. We're also without Boris Ovson this weekend coming up. So big changes to the defence for the upcoming game away to Mornington?
Yeah, well, it puts you're trying to settle your defence, and we've still not got it right, as I said before. We've still got a couple of players to come in certain key positions, which hopefully will happen before the halfway mark. And we're hoping to get Kieran back very shortly. But also the good news is Nick Thorogood's back training tonight, so he's a very, very capable player and a good defender.
So obviously this is the first time with Mornington being fairly dominant in State League One South East for the last couple of years. This is the first time when Lang Warren go in above Mornington for a while. What does that mentality do, or what does that do for the mentality of the players going in?
Well, it's more, for my mentality, it's 6 points clear of them. And the most important thing is you don't get beat up there next week. I mean, if we walk away with a point, then I'll be quite happy. But I've never went down to Mornington with such a strong squad as what we've got at the moment. So we're confident, but it's going to be one hell of a game. Mornington will not lie down, and I know Jamo and I know the players, and they'll be up for it. But our players have got to be up for it. I was a wee bit disappointed with some of your players on Saturday who couldn't handle the pressure too well. But once they came to grips with the game, the quality shone through, and I'm quite sure it'll shine through on Saturday when we play Mornington. I'm really looking forward to the game, and it'll be a cracker.
And with a number of new players, obviously, who haven't been here for the last couple of years, how do you think they'll cope with the derby atmosphere and, the tasty type of fixture that Mornington is?
Well, they'll be told on Thursday night what it means to the supporters and the club and the coaching staff and even the players who have been with us for the last couple of years. Mornington's had, obviously, the results over us, and if that kind of get them up. We've got a lot of winners in the team, and it'll just be up to them on the day to make sure that they're primed and they're right and they're ready to go. Mornington, as I say, they're a good side, and let's not be kidding on about it. So we've got two very difficult away games before we come back at home. So we've got Clifton Hill away. So we'll worry about this Saturday and see how we go. But I'm very confident that we can get in there and put on a good show.
So let's take a look at the scores from the weekend just gone and then a preview of next week's fixtures. Casey Comets on Friday night recorded a massive 5-1 win over Muirlbark. This week's opponents, Mornington, had a dramatic 3-3 draw with Caulfield, with a couple of goals in the last 10 minutes there, really making that one to watch. St Kilda had a 2-1 home win against Clifton Hill, whilst Malvern probably with the upset of the week, with a 2-1 win over the stout Warrego United team. And of course, the other game this week was Morwell at home to South Springvale, and the away team there, South Springvale, getting the 1-0 win. And of course, let's have a look at this week's fixtures coming up. And Warrego United host Morwell Pegasus in the Gippsland Derby. Obviously, Mornington hosting Lang Warren down at Dallas Brooks Park. Muirlabark hosting St Kilda. Manningham versus FC Clifton Hill. Caulfield United against Malvern City. And South Springvale hosting Casey Comets. We are joined by new signing and goal scoring machine Liam Baxter, who recently joined us from GV Suns in the NPL2. I'm going to catch up and find out how Liam's been settling in. Liam, it's been a whirlwind couple of weeks since you started at Langy. How have you settled in with the boys?
Really good. I'm really enjoying it, and it's a good laugh, and the team's going well, so pretty good.
You've been involved in goals, whether you've claimed them, scored them, or got them in through deflections. What's been your secret for the first few weeks?
Chicken nuggets, I think. No, I don't know. I just seem to be in the right place at the right time, or I don't know.
There's a lot of chat about the level of State League 1 compared to the level of NPL 2. There's not many players that make that switch in between mid-season. You've done that yourself. How do you find the level of not only Lang Warren, but the teams you're playing against, as compared to the teams you played against in NPL 2?
It's a lot more fast-paced and aggressive. Like, the tackles are a lot harder, in your face, more physical. You get a lot more time in the NPL 2, I think. And the teams are pretty good, to be honest. I think we would be up there in the NPL 2, in my opinion. But just whether it would happen or not.
Obviously, an interrupted early season when you're with GV Suns, involved in a car accident. Also, that came with some injury troubles. What injuries came from that?
My hip, got a hematoma in my hip, and that was still giving me a wee bit of jip now, but just playing through it. Was at the physio last week, and I've got to get an MRI scan on it and then see how we go from there. But it's just causing me pain at the moment. It's not causing me anything like to carry on being injured or that. So
excellent. And look, also we've got a big game against Mornington. I'm sure the boys have G'd you up about what it means to be Mornington. So you're looking forward to that game?
I can't wait. That's the games you want to play, and especially going for the league and hopefully being invincible the whole season, a bit like Celtic. We want to go out and make a statement and hopefully do them. Well, good and proper.
I'm sure Gus will love the mention of the Celtic Invincibles. Thanks very much for joining us tonight, Liam. Thanks. We asked the boys a few more questions, so check out their responses. What's the best bit about playing for Langy?
The lads and the coaches.
The lads and the stuff.
Getting to live with your mates, and the banter's good. And the club doesn't disagree with drinking, so we all fit in well.
Great club and a great bunch of lads.
Playing under Gus.
The night out after.
The watermelon before training from Tuxi.
Playing under Gus.
With all the lads.
Just the boys. The boys are really good here, yeah.
The boys are a great bunch of guys.
Playing with a big family.
Who takes the longest to get ready post-match?
Yaya.
Aaron.
Belge.
Aaron.
Yaya.
Yaya.
Aaron.
Belge.
Yaya.
Aaron.
Aaron.
Oh, Sergio.
Me. Not gonna lie.
All right, mate, how are you?
Yeah, good, mate. What are you doing? Keep
your uppies? I do, keep your
Oh no!
And back.
Oh!
Let's have a look at this week's league table. Before we close the show, here's a little bit of inspiration before this weekend's big derby match.
Oh,
That's all for Langy TV Midweek Roundup this weekend. Got the big game against Mornington on Saturday, although Saxon Productions and Langy TV won't be streaming it. Mornington Soccer Club will be streaming it and we will be sharing that stream, and of course all the normal Facebook updates for away games that you're used to. Big shout out to Roddy Strachan, who stepped in and left the filled the void left by Saxon Productions in order to get you guys some highlights of the Manningham game. Thank you very much for your help there, Roddy. But make sure you stay tuned in to Langy TV Midweek Roundup, as well as the live stream for this week.